My name is Lydia Sakeniluka. I'm a pastor married to Bishop Bright Luka. We have 4 children together. I'm also the executive director for Bukata Empowerment Foundation. I was doing nothing, and my husband was working for Zesco. And where he was working, he was getting about 180 kwacha. We used to sleep even without food. We used to struggle. I remember one day, we slept 2 days without food. And my neighbors were frying. They were frying food, and us, we had nothing. And my second-born son started crying for food. And he was chased by my neighbor. You know how the behavior is in our compounds. So what I did was, I had one pair of my shoe, and I said, Lord, I'm going to sell this pair of shoe. I went to Kalingalinga market near the ground, Kalingalinga ground, and I sold the pair of the shoe that I had at 25 kwacha. I removed 15 kwacha, and I bought sweet potatoes, sugar, yopimisa, and other things for food to go and eat with my kids. The 10 kwacha that remained, what I did with that money, I decided to go and buy flour, and I bought cooking oil, yopimisa, and I started making fritters and samosas. I opened the shop because I had a vision that I also want to have my own shop. I want to have my own workers. I want to have my own keys. And that's how now, because in the compound, people, when they see someone is, the business is growing, what they only think is ni mankwala, or maybe wanaguli samayezi, things like that. And I started explaining to the women, because a lot of people now, they knew where I came from. So when my husband stopped work, I encouraged him that you should not just sit, you should not just be a full-time minister of the word. Let's do the business together. I encouraged him. Until now, we started working together. This time, I'm giving back to the community. I'm helping a lot of people, even when the organization have no funds. But I still help. I have these programs that I'm running, the Go Back to School campaign, getting the children that dropped out from school back to school. When we open the bells, we don't sell everything. That thing that remains, we keep them. Every after 2 months, I meet these people, the old age, and we give them the clothes. The clothes that we give them is not for them just to wear them. It's one way of empowering them, because I do encourage them to go and sell and to go and exchange with crops or pottery. I'm contributing to the well-being of my society. But when you look at how I started very small. Business is not about millions. It's about the brain, the mindset, and the vision. So that's what I can say. Yeah, thank you so much.